Hello, my name is Pat Staley, and I'm the Client Relations Manager with SyncFusion. Today, we're going to discuss flat license portal training. Why does this matter to me? Because it's important to understand the benefits of the license management portal, how portals and licenses are assigned, and then how to navigate through a portal. The benefits of the license portal management gives you the ability to manage multiple portals. It's important to note that SyncFusion offers three types of flat licenses. We have a project license, a division license, and a global license. If you are a project license holder, you do not have the ability to have multiple versions. But if you do have a division or a global license with SyncFusion, you will have the ability to manage multiple portals with different versions of SyncFusion. This is important to understand and the value in regards to any legacy development that you have. If you've been acquired or are part of a merger and you need to keep that development separate. Also, in regards to stability and consistency in managing incidents, especially when a company has multiple versions. Legacy development is so valuable to so many customers of ours. It's important to note that we recognize that it may be too costly for you to migrate to a newer version. In regards to budget, there might not be any. Also, it might be too labor intensive, and you certainly don't want to mess with stable. The stability and consistency of managing incidences is equally important. We value all of our clients and how important their time is. For us to be able to turn around issues and incidents quickly, when you have your users registered in your portal, it means that our support team can keep that single thread so that everybody's informed of the latest patch or fix that is going on with the issue that has been registered. It also means that if you do have multiple versions, everything is in that one spot and our support team isn't confused by who belongs to where. The benefit of the license management portal gives you the ability to have stability and consistency in regards to your incidents. Each portal has a place to report and communicate the incident that belongs to that version. It also means that everyone who's involved with that project can see the results of the fix or the patch that has happened with the issue that they've registered. We also want to make sure that they're registering their issues and their incidences in the portal and not in the forum. It's important to note that our support team looks for that single line, that single thread, so that we know what's happening in regards to the latest development that you're doing, and the incident management portal is the best place to document that. Your portal offers you four types of users: the portal administrator, technical admin, power user, and user. If you are a company who monitors the distribution of all of your software licenses, it's important to note that we offer the capability for you to do that. You don't have to assign an individual user a license, but by having them in the portal means that they can check and be a part of the incident management tracking that goes on. A portal administrator is responsible for everything in the portal. They assign, they can create, they can delete users. A technical admin may be that person that you want to receive and get all of the emails that are associated from a technical point of view regarding incidences and issues. A power user has the right to create new users if you have sub-levels of projects going on. And then you have your user. It's important to note that we want to be able to help our clients with security and privacy, and certainly these different user types assist with that. Now let's take a look at the portal. By logging into www.syncfusion.com, on the right-hand side of the screen, you'll see a sign-in button. Click it and enter your email address. And enter your password. You can click Keep Me Logged In, or you can choose to keep it off, your choice, and then sign in. Once you've signed in, you'll notice that your name is over on the right-hand side and it says, Hi, Pat Staley. We want to go ahead and click My Account. Once this is launched, you are in your portal management page. You have support where you'll register your incidents, look at patches, see features, issues and forums, and support plans. And then you're going to also have your product. This is all on the left-hand side. Product, license and keys, downloads, my order, renew, and license management. We're going to start at the bottom and work our way up. So let's discuss license management first. On this page, all of your portals will be listed out here under All Portals. You have the ability, once you select your portal, to either delete it, to look at the settings, and then to assign and manage your users. When we click the Settings button, we see here that the name of the portal comes up. We can choose whichever one we want to look at. Because with the global license, you do have the ability to have multiple users. You also have the ability to have multiple versions. So in this case, I'm looking at Pat's company, and the version is 14.3.0.49. And if you click the drop-down button, you see that we have all of the different versions of SyncFusion listed. We have the ability here to select the authority level that we want our user to have. If you are a company that does not allow a developer to download software directly, you want to capture that and make sure that you are responsible to prevent any sort of privacy, then you might not want to assign that license. If you are a non-technical person, you may also not want to receive any of the technical emails that will come whenever incidences are being logged and the progress of those incidences. If that's the case, if you would like to assign someone to be responsible from a technical point of view while you maintain control of the assignage of those licenses, you would choose a technical admin. If you have a project and you have several project leaders and you know that you want to have different assigning rights for that, you could assign a power user, and inside of that portal, this person would be able to create and delete user licenses as well. We try to do this so that it gives you more control over what your users are doing. If you do not have any preference, then you can leave all of them blank, and it will assume that you are the admin, which it will automatically default to. In looking at Pat's company, we have a total of 19 licenses. We have 17 available and only 2 assigned. So let's go ahead and click in and take a look at our users. When I click the View button, it will launch to the page where I now am able to see all of the users as well as their authority rights. If I say I wish to create a new user, I can click the Create button, and I have the option to either add a single user or add a multiple user. When we click Add Multiple Users, you will see that you have an Excel template that will open. Once this opens, it gives you the format that we need for you to be able to add all of your users by adding their email ID, their full name, a phone number, and the project that they are going to be associated with. To upload that, simply save it to your desktop, browse, and upload that document. To create a single user, click Create, New User, Add Single User. Type in the name and their email address and a phone number. Select the project you want them to be associated with and click Add User. By clicking the OK button, you'll see that Whitney has now been added. Now we want to assign her license as well as giving her permissions. By clicking the 3 buttons on the right-hand side, we have the ability to edit, move, delete, and assign a role. We're going to edit this license and give her an active license. We click the check mark, and now our user count changes from 17 to 16, and we have 3 licenses assigned. To change Whitney's role, we click the 3 buttons, Role, and we're going to make her a power user. By clicking OK and answering yes, we now see that Whitney is a power user. Again, you have complete control over what you want your users to be able to do or not do. Even if your users are not assigned, you need to have them registered in the portal, because when we go over the incident management process, you'll see the importance of having that there. In taking a look at your portal, it's important to realize that you may have multiple projects that you want to be able to use Sync Fusion's controls, assemblies, and grids with. Especially if you're working with a legacy product that's very old, you don't want that to inhibit you from using some of the newer products. If we take a look at the two portals that we have here, what's important to note is Pat's company is running on 14.3.0.49, while Dylan's test portal is running on 14.2.0.32. Please make sure that you know that you can have the same user in both of these portals. You're not restricted to a single user being in a single portal. You'll also notice that in Dylan's portal, we have 19 total licenses, again with 3 assigned. When we take a look at the portal setting, in looking at the two portals, we notice that Dylan's company and Pat's company all have still the total of 19 users. In Dylan's portal, he does not have anybody assigned. It's very simple to assign a person to a portal. Remember to make sure and assign her to a project. Once you click Add User, you'll see that Lori has been added to the portal, but we need to assign her a license and determine her role. Let's review what license and keys and downloads look like. Under Product, on the left-hand side of your page, click License and Keys, and here you'll be able to get an unlock key for your license. When you click the unlock key, a pop-up screen opens and you select the version that you want, and the key appears at the bottom of that pop-up screen. Please click the email button to send that key to whomever it is you wish to send it to, or copy it to a clipboard. It's very important to make sure that this is how you save that key. Once your key has been saved, you can go to Downloads, select what you're looking to download by selecting the download and link, click the executable. Once the executable has been added to your download tray, click the download. Once the download has finished, you can open it. Click yes, and it will walk you through the prompts. You always want to select product key. Click paste. The product key that you pasted on the clipboard will be entered. Click Next. In our account screen, the first page that opens up is where all of your incidents are. This will give you the list of anything that is opened, is closed, pending. This is your hub for all of your incident management. The importance for having all of your users registered in the license management portal is that everyone will be copied on this thread as long as they're registered in the portal. To create a new incident, we click the New Incident button. Our projects, we can choose if we have multiple projects which one we want to select. We click the platform for what we're looking for. And once we click the platform that's associated with this, you will see that the screen auto-populates to give us the exact information that we need for that particular platform and control. We don't have an option for a different product version because it's already populated. We understand that we have multiple browsers if we're looking at JavaScript to be able to choose what we're looking for. We would type in the subject line. And then inside the message, we would describe what our issue is. If you have any images or videos that you can attach or documents, please do so by attaching the file and selecting what you need. Click Create the Incident. And once the incident has been created, it will have your name, when it was created, and the details here regarding that incident. To be able to track this now, we will be able to come back to our account page, and here we see that this is a test and that it's open. If we want to modify this incident for additional details or to check status, we merely click on it and it will open up. We can reply if we have additional information to give. Once the incident has been taken care of and is closed, we also can close it out. A support feedback page will open. We always welcome feedback. Please make sure that you answer the questions and post your comments. We hope this video has been helpful, and if you need any further information or help with logging in and managing users, license and downloads, logging incidents, please contact Client Relations at SyncFusion.com.